Just recently, former aviation minister and spokesman for the Goodluck Jonathan presidential campaign, Femi Olukayode, otherwise known as Femi Fani Kayode, was rearrested by the EFCC just outside of court. Now, I really don't understand why they have rearrested Femi Fani Kayode. Why? I mean, this was a man, he was not a flight risk. You know, he lives right there in Abuja in Nigeria. The authorities had people on him. The man was absolutely no flight risk. You've already arrested him before. You know, he's out on bail, and then you've rearrested him. You know, you've locked him up somewhere, and then even the judge ordered that his phone be taken away from him. Now, just imagine that. Is it because he is a critic? Is it because he is a critic of this administration? This administration needs strong critics. They need critics. What has been done right now to Femi Fani Kayode, I believe it's unnecessary, and I believe it's very draconian. He was in detention for, I think, over 3 months. I mean, if you had, why are you bringing your charges against him piecemeal? Look, this idea of arresting people first and then investigating, it doesn't make sense. You do your investigations and then you arrest, except the reason for his arrest is to stop him from talking, because that's just the only thing I can see. The order that his phone be taken away from him. Because what is Femi Kayode doing? Is he lying? He's been telling the truth. He's been a conscience of this nation. Why should he be arrested? Why should he be thrown in jail? Now, I'm not saying that he should not be investigated. I'm not saying that he should not be tried. He had already been arrested. He had already been in detention for over 3 months, and then he perfected his bail, and then now you have thrown him into detention again, and then you now ask him to perfect new bail conditions. Why? Why? You see, it's happening to critics of this administration, and it's happening too much. And, you know, you and I have to speak up. Femi Fani Kayode is one of the foremost critics of this administration, and look at what's happened to him. Look, if you and I don't speak up about this, very soon you and I will not be able to speak up about anything. This administration, President Muhammadu Buhari, claims to be fighting corruption. If you Google me, you'll find out that I supported him at the beginning. I supported him initially because I thought that this was going to be a level playing ground. I thought that he was serious about fighting corruption. But this doesn't show seriousness. You claim to be fighting corruption, and then you invited a man like Rotimi Amaechi into your cabinet. Rotimi Amaechi, go and Google it. He admitted spending $500,000 to host Professor Wole Soyinka. He admitted spending $500,000 to host Professor Wole Soyinka. Who does that? Who does that? And then when he was asked, when there was so much pressure, and then he asked his then former Commissioner for Information, Ibim Seminatari, now the Managing Director of the Niger Delta Development Corporation, asked her to release a statement saying that, well, the money was not only spent on hosting him, they spent money on dancers, they spent money on accommodation. Look, I know how to dance. If they are going to spend $500,000 to host Wole Soyinka and they want me to dance for them, I can come and dance. They should pay me the $500,000. I have a house. I can keep Professor Wole Soyinka in that house. Let them pay me the $500,000. What cheek? Can you imagine? Look, in 2013, President Jonathan played host to the British Prime Minister David Cameron. He came to Nigeria. President Jonathan did not spend up to $50,000 hosting the British Prime Minister. How can you now tell us that you spent $500,000 hosting Professor Wole Soyinka and then you are there? You're sitting down as a minister with this same President Buhari who is claiming to be fighting corruption. Okay, what about Rajiv Fashola? I have a lot of respect for him because of what he was said to have achieved in Lagos. You know, I really have tremendous respect for him. But this is a man who admitted that he paid 78 million naira for his website. Go there, Google it. These things I'm telling you, I only speak on facts because I don't want to be sued. I have a master's in law. If I'm going to talk, I speak on facts. Google it yourself. As I'm speaking to you right now, Google it. As I'm speaking to you right now, Google it. He spent $78 million on his site, paid for by taxpayers' money. And then at the time that he did this, I believe this was 2013, 2014, that amount of money was over $500,000, over $500,000. Listen, he was asked, how could you have spent such a huge amount on your site? He said, well, it is for hosting the site, for maintaining the site, for configuring the sites to different platforms. Listen, I'm an IT person. I was special assistant on new media. You can do all that for 1% of that amount, 1% of that amount. Even for hosting Wole Soyinka, you could have hosted Wole Soyinka for 1% of that amount. Chip Buke wrote to me, Amechi spent $500,000 to host Wole Soyinka. You can host Wole Soyinka for even $5,000. So these are the people that you have in your administration, and then you say that you are fighting corruption. What kind of corruption are you fighting when corruption is there, sitting right in front of you, during your federal executive council meetings regularly? And now you have gone to go and arrest Femi Fani-Kayode. The money that was spent by the All Progressive Congress during their presidential elections, where did it come from? Where did it come from? The other time, I believe it was Premium Times during the election, as our reporters, they leaked emails between, Wotimi Amaechi and one other person with the American consultants. Who paid for that? Who paid for all the monies that were being spent? And then now you are going to go and arrest. How many people have been arrested for funding the APC campaign? Was it ghosts that funded the APC campaign? Was it debts? Did Mr. President go and borrow money to fund this campaign? We are talking about Nigeria, a highly cash incentive country. Who paid for their campaigns? Look, what I'm telling you, I'm not saying that that Femi Fani-Kayode should not be arrested. But the thing is he had been arrested once, you have all your cases against him, you arrest him once, and then the man goes to court, you charge him to court, and then he gets bail. And then when he gets bail, you allow him to go to court to be tried. But what is happening right now, this man is a major critic of the government. He starts to criticize you, and then you have him rearrested. So he will now go through the whole process again. No, I do not buy that. Because if it can happen to him, it can happen to anybody. And I urge Nigerians, what is happening right now is unfair. Our nation is being turned into a police state. And so some people are saying, okay, they're going to arrest me. Even if they kill me, what does the Bible say? This is the word of Jesus. He said, fear not those who can kill the body, and then afterwards they have nothing that they can do to the soul. I will tell you who you should fear. You should fear God, who, after he has killed the body, he can also kill the soul in hell. So how can we keep quiet when these things are happening? And then we say that we are Christians, we say that we are Muslims. This is the word of God. It says, love your neighbor as yourself. If I cannot love Femi Fani-Kayode as myself and fight for him over this injustice, then I should not fight for myself. And I urge you, think about these things I've said. God bless you.